find in my heart that I had not a hard heart, for truly, I love none.
A dear happiness to women!
They would have else been troubled with a pernicious suitor. I thank the god and my cold blood. I love your humor for that. I had rather hear my dog bark at a crow than a man swear he loves me.
Oh, well, I'll keep your ladyship still in that mind, so some gentleman or other shall escape a predestined scratch face.
Scratching could not make it work as it were such a face as yours were.
Oh! 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 I would my horse at the speed of your tongue. That's it, keep your way. I've said it. I've done.
You always end in a jade's trick, I know you of old.
Signor Clio, and Signor Benedict, my dear friend Leonato, have invited you all. I tell him we shall stay at the least a month.
Poor man.
Hey!
Name
Mock not, mock not. Ere you flout old ends any further, examine your conscience. And so I leave you.
My liege, your highness may not do me some good.
My love is thine to teach.
Wow.
Teach it, but how?
Happily not own son, my lord.
No child but hero. She is its only heir. Dost thou affect her, Claudio?
Oh, my lord, when you went onward on this ended action, I looked upon her with a soldier's eye that light. I had a rougher task in hand to drive light in the name of love. But now I am returned, and those war thoughts have left their rooms vacant. In their places come thronging soft and delicate desires, all prompting me how soft and fair your hero is, saying I like dear, I went to wars.
Thou wilt be like a lover presently, and tire the hearer with a book of words. If thou dost love, fair hero, cherish it, and I will fit thee with a remedy. I know we will have some reveling tonight. I will assume thy part in some disguise and tell fair hero I am Claudio! Then take her here, you prisoner, with the force and strong encounter of my amorous tale. Then to her father I will break, and the conclusion is she shall be thine! In practice, let us put it presently.
Midway between him and Benedict. The one who, like
Enjoy your good company. lord.
The count is neither sad, nor sick, nor married, nor well, but civil count, civil as an orange, and something of that jealous complexion.
Faith, lady, I think you're blazing to be true. Although, if it be so, his conceit is false. Yeah, Claudio! I have wooed in your name, and fair hero is won. I have broke with her father, and his good will obtained. Name the day of marriage, and God give you joy.
Count, take of me my daughter, and with her my fortune. His grace hath made the match, and all grace say, amen to it.
Speak, count, 'tis your cue.
Silence is the perfectest herald of joy. I were a little happy if I could say how much. Lady, is you are mine, I am yours.
Speak, coven, or if you cannot, stop his mouth with a kiss and let him not speak either.
In faith, lady, you have a very heart.
Yea, my lord, I thank you. Keeps me on the windy side of care. My cousin tells him in his ear that he is in her heart.
Oh, so she does, cousin.
Cousin, God give you joy.
By my troth! Pleasant spirited lady.
There's little of the melancholy element in her, my lord.
She cannot endure to hear tell of a husband.
She mocked all her wars out of suits.
She were an excellent wife for Betty.
Lord, my lord, if they were but a week married, they would talk themselves mad.
Claudio, we need you to go to church.
Tomorrow, my lord, time goes on crutches till love has all his rights.
Ah, not till Monday, my dear son. Just a hint of 7 night, and a time too brief, too, to have all things out of my mind.
Come, you shake your head so long breathing, but I warn you, Claudio, that the time will not go duly by us. I will, in the interim, undertake one of Hercules' labors, which is to bring Signor Benedick and the Lady Beatrice into our mountain of affection. The one with the other. I would fain have it a match, and I doubt not but to fetch it. If you four would minister to me such assistance as I will give you direction.
My lord, we are for you, though it cost us 10 night washings.
And I, my lord.
And you too, gentle hero.
I will do any modest office, my lord, to help my cousin to a good husband.
If we can do this, Cupid is no longer an archer. His glory shall be ours! For we are the only love gods. Hands
Claudio, to undo hero and to kill Leonardo.
Only to despite them, I will never anything.
Be you constant in this accusation, and my union shall not shame me.
I shall presently go learn the day of their marriage.
She's
daughter tell you how.
He did indeed. How? I pray you.
I should think this a gull, and that the white-bearded fellow speaks it. Sure, hide itself in such reverence.
Hath taken the infection. Hold it up.
I pray you. Hath she made her
affection
known to Benedick?
No, and swear she never will. That's her torment.
Then down upon her knees she falls, weeps, sobs, tears her hair, beats her heart, curses, and prays.
Never think to marry.
I must not seem proud. Happy are they that hear their detractions and can put them to mend. They say the lady is fair. 'Tis the truth. I can bear them witness. And virtuous? 'Tis so, I cannot reprove it. And wise, but for loving me. By my troth, it is no great addition to her wit, nor no great argument of her folly, for I will be horribly in love with her!
Claudio,
when are you having
that? Every day, tomorrow. Come, go in. wash his face.
Aye, that tells a heavy tale for him.
Conclude he is in love.
Yet is this no cure for the toothache?
Old Senor, walk about with me. I have studied 8 or 9 wise words with which to speak with you, which these hobby horses must not hear.
How peaceable way for you, if you do take a thief, is to let him show himself what he is and steal out of your company. Truly, I would not hang a dog by my will, much more a man who hath any honesty in him. Well, neighbors, good night. Envy me any matter of weight chances. Call me up. Keep your fellows' counsels and your own den. Good night. Come, neighbor. Well, masters, we hear our charge. Let us go and sit upon the church bench until 2:00. And then I'll go to bed. One word more, honest neighbors. I pray you, watch about Signor Leonato's door. For the wedding being there tomorrow, there's a great coil tonight. And you, be vigilant, I beseech you.
Be brief, I pray you, for you see, it is a busy time for us.
Mary, this it is, sir.
Yes. Neighbors, you are tedious.
It pleases your worship to say so, but we are the poor duke's offices. Truly, for mine own part, if I were as tedious as a king, I wouldn't find it in my heart to bestow it all of your worship.
All thy tediousness on me? Ah, I may know what you have to say.
Mary, sir, our watch may accept you your worship's presence. Has taken a couple of errant knaves as any in this
city. I'm a good old man, sir.
He will be talking.
We must leave.
One word, sir!
Our watch indeed, sir, hath comprehended three auspicious persons, and we would have them this morning examined.
Your worship.
You take their examination yourself and bring it us. We are now in good haste, as may it appear unto you.
It shall be sufficient. Drink some wine, there you go. Very
examination these men.
If we must do it wisely,
we'll spare no wit, I warrant you. Here's a shall drive some of them into a non-commit. Only get the learned writer to set down our excommunication and meet me at jail.
Let us go. These
think it's come thus to life. Smother her spirits up. How about the lady?
Dead, I think. Hero, why hero? Uncle, Signor Benedict Friar.
Death is the fairest cover for a shame. That may be wished for.
How now, cousin Hero? Have comfort, lady.
Dost thou look up?
Ye, wherefore does she not?
Wherefore? Why, does not every earthly thing cry shame upon her?
Do not live, Hero. Do not ope thy eye. Grieve I had but one. Oh, one too much by thee. Why had I one? Why was thou ever lovely in my eyes? But mine I love, and mine I crave, and mine I was proud on, and mine so much that I myself was myself, not mine. Vowing of her, why, she... Ah! She's fallen! Into a pit of ink that the wide sea has dropped too few to wash it clean again.
Sir, be patient. For mine own part, I'm so tired in wonder, I know not what to say.
Oh, my soul, my cousin is belied!
Would the two princes lie? And Claudio lie, who loved her so that, speaking of her fountain, washed it with tears?
Hence, myrrh! Let her die!
Hear me a little. By noting of the lady, I had marked 1,000 blushing apparitions to start into her face. Call me a fool. If this my lady lie not guiltless here, under some biting air, there is some as prison in the princes.
Two of them have the very bent of honor. Their wisdom is being misled in this. Practice of it lives in John the Bastard, whose spirits toil in the frame of villainies.
If they wrong her honor, the proudest of them shall hear of it.
Pause a while, and let my counsel sway you this case. Your daughter here, the princess, left for dead. Let her while be secretly kept in, and publish her that she is dead indeed.
What shall become of this? What will this do?
This little carriage shall on her behalf chase slander to remorse. That is some good. But not for that death, I on the strange course. But look for greater birth. This will carriage shall... This should change the slander to remorse. And that is some good. And every hearer shall lament, pity, and excuse. So will it bear with Claudio. When he shall hear she died upon his words, the idea of her life will sweetly creep into his study of imagination. Then he will mourn and wish that he had not so accused her. No, though he thought his accusations true.
Signor Leonardo, let the friar advise you.
Being that I flow in grief, the small twine may leave me.
'Tis well consented, presently away. Come, lady, thy to live this wedding day. Have patience and endure.
Lady Beatrice, have you wept all this while?
Yea, and I will weep a while longer.
I will not desire that.
You have no reason, I do it freely.
Surely I do believe your fair cousin is wrong.
How much might the man deserve of me that would right her?
Is there any way to show such friendship? I do love nothing in the world so well as you. It's not that strange.
I think God forgive me.
What offense, sweet Beatrice?
I was about to protest I loved you.
And do it with all thy heart.
I love you with so much of my heart, there is nothing left to protest.
Oh, bid me do anything for thee.
Kill Claudio.
Not for the wide world.
Stay, I pray you, let me go!
Beatrice!
Stay, I will go!
I love thee.
Use it for my love. Some other way than my sacrifices.
Think you, in your soul, that Count Claudio hath wronged Hero?
Yea, as sure as I have a thought or soul.
Enough. I am engaged. I will challenge you. By this hand, Claudio shall render me a dear account. As you hear of me, so think of me. Go comfort your cousin. I must say she is dead. And so, farewell.
Down the fool. 'Tis not wisdom thus to second grief against yourself.
I pray you, cease thy counsel, which falls into mine ear as profitless as waterness is. Bring me a father that so loved his child, whose joy I have heard is overwhelmed like mine. If such a one will smile and stroke his beard, bring him yet to me, and I of him will gather patience.
But there is no such man. For, brother, men can counsel and give comfort to that grief which they themselves not know. But, upon tasting it, their counsel turns to passion.
No, no. 'Tis all men's office to speak patience to those that grieve under the load of sorrow. But no man's virtue nor sufficiency can be so moral he shall endure the life himself. Therefore, give me no counsel.
Yet bend not all the harm upon yourself. Make those that do offend you suffer too.
There, thou speaketh reason.
Nay,
I would you so. My soul doth tell me that Hero is belied.
And that shall the prince know, and so shall Claudio, and all that thus dishonor her.
Here comes the prince and Claudio hastily.
Good day, good day.
Hey, you, sir.
My lords, we have some haste, Leonato.
Some haste? Well, very well, my lord.
Are you so hasty now? Well, all is one.
Nay, do not quarrel with us, old man.
If he could right himself of quarreling, some of us would lie low.
Who wrongs him?
I say
that hath belied my innocent child. Thy slayer has gone through and through her heart, and she lies buried with her anger. Oh, in a tomb where never scandal slept, save this of hers framed by thy villainy.
My villainy?
Thy, Claudio. Thy, I say!
You say not right, old man.
My lord, I'll prove it on his body. If he dare.
Away, away. I'll not have to do with thee.
Hang up so darkly. Thou killed my child. If thou killest me, boy, thou shalt kill a man.
Ha!
He shall kill two of us and mend thee. Come, follow me, boy. Come, sir, boy. Come, follow me. Sir, boy. Nay, gentlemen, brother, content yourself. I loved my niece, and she is slandered to death by villains, boys, apes, braggarts, jacks, milk sauce.
Brother Anthony!
Content yourself. Tis no matter. Do not you meddle. Let me deal in this.
We will not await your patience.
She was charged with nothing but what was true and very full of proof.
My lord, my lord!
I will not hear you!
No. Come, brother and wife, away. We will be heard!
And shall, some of us will smart, lords.
Now award you for the love of Beatrice.
and hath challenged thee?
Most sincerely.
Come, you sir! If justice cannot take you, she shall never win more reasons in her belt. Nay, and you be a cursing hypocrite once, you must be looked to.
How now? Two, three,
two and a half of my brother's men!
Your worship speaks like a most thankful and reverent youth.
And knows me? Mary, I cannot show it in rhyme. I've tried. I can find no rhyme to lady but baby. An innocent rhyme for scorn, horn. A hard rhyme, for school, fool. A babbling rhyme, very ominous endings. No, I was not born under a rhyming plant. Nor can I woo in festival terms.
Sweet Beatrice!
Wouldst thou come when I call thee?
Yes, senor. And depart when you bid me.
Stay! But till then...
Then is spoken, and so farewell. And yet, ere I go, let me go with that I came, which is in knowing what hath passed between you and Claudio.
Only foul words, and thereupon will I kiss thee.
Foul words are but foul wind, and foul wind is but foul breath. And foul breath is noisome, therefore I will depart unkissed.
Thou hast frighted the word right out of his right sense, so forcible is thy wit. But I must tell thee plainly, Claudio undergoes my challenge. Neither I must hear from him shortly or subscribe him a coward. Now, I prithee, tell me, for which of my bad parts didst thou first fall in love with me?
For them all together, which have made so politic a state of evil that they have not allowed any good parts to intermingle with you. But for which of my good parts did you first suffer love for me?
Suffer love? Ha! A good epithet! I do suffer love indeed, for I love thee against my will.
In spite of your heart, I think, alas, poor heart. If you spite it for my sake, I shall spite it for yours, for I cannot love that which my friend hates.
Thou and I are too wise to woo peaceably. Now, tell me, how doth your cousin?
Very ill.
How do you?
Very ill, too.
Serve God. Love me. And men. There will I leave you two, for here comes one in haste.
With that, you must meet your uncle. It is proved my lady hero have been falsely accused, the prince and Claudio mightily abused, and Don John is the author of all, who is fled and gone.
Is the monument of Signor Leonardo?
It is, my lord.
Done to death by slanderous tongues was the hero that here lies. Death in Gidron of her wrongs gives her fame which never dies. And so the life that died in shame now lives in death for glorious fame. Now unto thy bones, good night, yearling. I do this right.
Did I not tell you she was innocent? And so are the prince and Claudio, who accused her upon the error you heard debated.
Well, I'm glad all things sorts.
So am I. Danielle's by faith been forced to call young Claudio to a reckoning for it.
Well, daughter,
bind me, or to undo me, one of them. Signor Leonardo, the truth it is, good signor, your niece regards me with an eye of favor.
Side bearer, I think you had from us. Claudio and the prince. But what's your will?
Your answer, sir, is enigmatical. But for my will is your goodwill may stand with ours. This day to be conjoined in a state of honorable marriage. In which, good friar, I shall desire your help.
My heart is with your liking.
And my help. Here come the Prince and Claudio.
Good morrow on this fair assembly.
Good morrow, Prince. Good morrow, Claudio. We here tell you, are you yet determined to marry with my brother's daughter?
I'll hold my mind where she needs you.
Call it forth, brother. Here's the friar ready.
How dost thou, Bennet?
Since I do purpose to marry, I will think nothing to any purpose that the world can say against it, and therefore never flout at me for what I have said against it. For your man is a giddy thing, and this is my conclusion. Come, come. We are friends. Let's have a dance ere we are married, that we may lighten our own hearts and our wives' heels.
We'll have dancing afterward.
Prince, thou art sad. Get thee a wife, get thee a wife. Brave punishments for him. Strike up, pipers!
Take him away!